Winds in the east, there's a mist coming in, like something is brewing and about to begin. Can't put me finger on what lies in store, but I feel what's to happen's all happened before. A father, a mother, a daughter, a son, the threads of their lives are all raveling undone. Something is needed to twist the mast tight, as a string you might use when you're flying a kite. Chim chimani, chim chim, chari chim charu.
Jane, let's run.
Get back here, you little blighters. You've got to do your lessons.
I can't do my lessons if I'm flying a kite.
And you can't make us. You're only a nanny.
Oi! Not you two again. Come here. Come along, though.
Good morning, Bert.
Morning, Mrs. Locke. And how's little Willoughby to die?
Oh, very well. Thank you, Bert. Willoughby!
My Jove, is that the beauteous Miss Locke I spy on the horizon?
Oh, Admiral. Willoughby.
Morning, Admiral. How's it looking?
Dark clouds, moon of number 17.
Of all London byways where I doff my cap, this one's the hardest to find on a map. Cherry Tree Line, as sweet as a song, but the nannies who come here, they don't stay for long. Chim chimani, chim chim, cherry chim charu.
Katie Nana! Katie Nana!
Those little beasts have run away from me for the last time.
And who gets stuck with the children with no nanny in the house? Me, that's who.
I've said my say, Miss Brill, and that's all I'll say. I'm done with this house forever.
Fine, and mind you don't stumble on your way out.
Katie Nana, where are you going? Katie Nana!
Katie Nana's gone, and is it any wonder, driven half demented by your children's pranks?
Do you really think I made another blunder? What on earth am I to say to Mr. Banks? George, dear, I'm feeling so bereft, dear. Another nanny's left, dear. Every nanny goes, we're unlucky, I suppose.
We are never going to find the perfect nanny.
Nonsense! Precision and order, that's all that I ask. The running of our household, a straightforward task. The children, the servants, are all your domain, whilst I remain the sovereign of Cherry Tree Lane. Coat! The simple truth is, you've engaged 6 nannies over the last 4 months, and they've all been unqualified disasters. A nanny should govern, a nanny should rule. A nanny is a paragon who suffers no fool. A nanny's a stalwart our children would gain by having such a nanny in Cherry Tree Lane.
Of course, George, but...
So take control of situations. show your authority when interviewing staff. You know your role. They know their stations. Efficiency and forethought cut the jobs in half. Briefcase!
I thought Katie Nana would be firm with the children. She always looked so cross.
Winifred, never confuse efficiency with a liver complaint. Umbrella!
If only we could find someone like your old nanny.
I'm afraid that's not realistic, my dear. Few women alive can match Miss Andrews' standards of efficiency. Besides, you can never afford someone of her caliber.
Precision and order, he wants nothing less. It's like an army barrack.
Yes, and we're in the mess.
No wonder the nannies are driven insane. We're living in a madhouse in Cherry Tree Lane.
Now, Winifred, if you do want to please me...
You know I do, George.
Very well. Then place an advertisement in the Times stating that Jane and Michael Banks require the best possible nanny at the lowest possible wage.
We'd better give them ours before they make another mistake.
Now, I would stress that...
Father, what's that you're holding, dear?
We've written our own advertisement.
What on earth?
Please, George, I think we should hear it.
Now, Winifred, none of your theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen.
Wanted a nanny for two adorable children.
Adorable? Well, that's debatable, I must say.
If you want this choice position, have a cheery disposition, rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's the part I put in.
Play games, all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty, very sweet and fairly pretty.
What of all the ridiculous...
George, please.
Take us on outings, give us treats.
Sing songs, bring sweets. Never be cross or cruel. Never feed us castor oil or gruel.
Wah! Love us as a son and daughter.
And never smell of barley water.
I put that bit in too.
If you won't scold and dominate us, we will never give you cause to hate us. We won't hide your spectacles so you can't see.
Put toads in your bed or pepper in your tea.
Hurry, nanny, many thanks, sincerely, Jane
and Michael
Banks.
All right. That is quite enough Tommy Rot for one day. Now, would you please go upstairs and let me get to work?
Morning.
Yes?
I've come in answer to the advertisement.
What advertisement? We haven't placed an advertisement. Not yet.
George and Winifred Banks live here, do they not?
Mr. and Mrs. Banks live here, yes.
And you are looking for a nanny?
Well, I suppose.
Very well, then. Now let me see. Play games, all sorts. Which I most certainly can. Take us on outings, give us treats.
Michael, it's our advertisement.
Rosy cheeks and fairly pretty. There's no objection on that score, I hope.
Oh, none at all.
I'm glad to hear it.
But take that up with Mrs. Banks. She handles all that side of things. Nothing domestic has anything to do with me. And don't forget the references.
I make it a rule never to give references.
But I thought it was usual.
A very old-fashioned idea to my mind. The best people never acquire them nowadays.
I see. You will have every third Thursday evening off from 5 until 9.
The best people give every second Wednesday from 6 till 8, ma'am. And that is what I shall take.
I see. Well, it's all settled then.
As long as I'm satisfied. I'll see the children now, thank you.
Of course. You'll find they're very... nice children. Now this is... oh.
Mary Poppins. Jane, don't stare. And close your mouth, Michael. We are not a codfish. Best foot forward. Spit spot.
Mrs. Brill, we have a new nanny.
She passed hinted you then?
Or I did.
Tidy, I must say. Tidier than I was expecting. Who's responsible for that?
Miss
Me.
Bill.
I am. I like to keep things neat.
Do you indeed? Well, I look forward to making use of that. If there's one thing I appreciate, it's a child whose word I can depend on. Who's he when he's at home?
That's Valentine. He's mine.
From the look on his face, I'm not sure he'd agree with you.
He's just a doll, and I don't want to play with him right now.
Treat him like that, and he might not want to play with you. Now, first things first. I always say the proper place to hang a hat is on a hat stand.
But there's nothing in it.
We'd better keep an eye on this one. She's tricky.
Mary Poppins, how could you have known what we wanted in a nanny when you made our list?
Your list? I'm not an item on the weekly shop, thank you very much.
How did you come? It was as if the wind just blew you here.
It did. Now, stand over there. Just as I thought. A noisy, mischievous, troublesome little boy.
You're making that up. A noisy, mischievous...
Now you! Thoughtless, short-tempered, and untidy.
I don't believe you. Let me see.
By the time the wind has blown the weather vane around, I'll show you if I can. No matter what the circumstance, for one thing I'm renowned. My character is spit spot spick and span.
What about your measurement, Mary Poppins?
I'm practically perfect in every way.
Practically perfect.
So people say. Each virtue virtually knows no bound. Each trait is great and patently sound. I'm practically perfect from head to toe. If I had a fault, it would never dare to show. I'm so practically perfect in every way. Both prim and proper and never too stern. Well educated yet willing to learn. I'm clean and honest, my manner refined. And I wear shoes of the sensible kind. I suffer no nonsense, and whilst I remain
There's nothing else I feel I need explain. I'm practically perfect in every way. Practically perfect, that's my forte. Uncanny nannies are hard to find. Unique yet meek, unspeakably kind. I'm practically perfect, not slightly soiled. Running like an engine that's just been freshly oiled. I'm so practically perfect in every way.
Well, those are my credentials. Perhaps you have a few questions?
Not temperamental.
Never.
Not grouchy or gruff.
Oh, the very thought.
Will you stay tender when the going gets tough?
Quite the contrary.
Do you read stories without a big fuss?
Mm-hmm.
Or have objections to playing with us?
Oh, I like games, but I choose them.
That's not fair.
Some minor improvements may not go amiss, but at all times you must remember this.
You're practically perfect in every way.
I guarantee.
Practically perfect. We hope you'll stay.
Each virtue virtually knows no bound. Each trait is great.
I'm perfectly sound.
Jane, Doll's house, please. Oh, I'll take my kettle, thank you.
That's not fair.
I never said I was fair. I said, I'm practically perfect, and here's my aim. By the time I leave here, you both will be the same. You'll be practically perfect. Best foot forward, spit spot.
Chim chimani, chim chimani, chim chim cheroo. I does what I likes, and I likes what I do. Today I'm a screever, and as you can see, a screever's an artist of highest degree. And it's all me own work, from me own memory.
Oh, lovey, not these again.
Come on, Mr. Parkkeeper, it's just me pictures, as it always is. There's no harm in them.
I'll be the judge of that. This is my park, and I say you're interfering with a public railing. I want to remove this. Just you watch it, that's all. Just you watch it.
White, stay right where you are. I'd know that silhouette anywhere. Mary Poppins.
It's nice to see you, Bert.
How does he know you? He can't know you. You've only just arrived.
I wasn't born 1 minute before I walked into your house, Michael Banks. Have you met these two, Bert?
Oh, I've seen him running. Chasing a kite.
It isn't real kite.
So what are you up to?
Mary Poppins says it's a game. It's called A Walk in the Park.
Some game. I'd rather eat spinach.
Come on, Bert. You're due for a break. And you promised you'd take me out when we met again. Or have you forgotten?
Of course I ain't married, but...
Oh, dear. Is that all you've got?
No.
Never you mind. My treat. And no one's charging for the trees in the sky, are they?
Mary Poppins, is he really coming with us?
Why shouldn't he?
Well, to start with, he's rather dirty, isn't he? Father would never approve.
You what?
You can't come with us. You're too dirty, and we don't want to go to the stinky park anyway.
Oh, yes, you do. Because when you walk in the park with Mary Poppins, you go places you've never even dreamed of. And if she says it's a dime, you can bet she has something in mind.
Is that a picture of the park?
No, it's not. Not our park, anyway. Look, that tree's a much brighter green, and the sky's quite a different blue.
I think you'll find it's just the way I've drawn it. Everybody's a critic. All that it takes is a spark. Then something, flying as a park, becomes a wonderland. All you have to do is look on you, then you'll understand why it's a jolly holiday with Mary. Mary makes your heart so light.
Oh, really?
When the day is gray and ordinary, Mary makes the sun shine bright.
You do talk nonsense, Bert.
Oh, happiness is blooming all around her. The daffodils are smiling at the dark.
I haven't the faintest idea about what
when
you're
Mary
talking about.
When Mary holds your hand,
Bert,
you feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band.
You've got enough brass for all of us.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder that it's Mary that we love. Oh, come along, you two.
Boring, just like other nannies thinking. Parks are good for us. It's just statues, ducks, and grannies. I don't understand all the fuss. Is she doing it despite us?
We could lose her for a lark. Perhaps it's all a plot. I'll tell you what, she seems so different, but I bet she's not. There is nothing to excite us in the park.
What was that?
You're quite wrong, you know. When you walk with Mary, anything can happen.
Who are you?
I'm Delius, and I've waited half a century to walk on a sunny day like this. Each man out with his dog will stand agog to see a statue take a gentle jog.
Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder that it's Mary that we love. Oh, it's a jolly holiday. Mary drank his heart so
Mary makes your heart so
proud to make a mark. When the light's bright,
happen?
Yes, but how?
Mary Poppins, of course.
How do you know Mary Poppins?
She's an old friend of my father's.
Your father? You're a statue. You can't have a father.
Well, if that's true,
why do I miss him so much?
Isn't he one of the other statues?
No, he lives very far away from here.
Do you really miss him?
Well, wouldn't you miss your father if you hardly ever saw him?
I'll have to think about that.
That's it! That's it! That's what it was!
What?
This half empty! The statue's gone!
Do you mean you've lost your marbles?
This is your fault, ain't it? I knew we should have trouble ever since you first arrived. Now we've got a statue missing. What? Oh, lovey.
Nelius, will you play with us again?
Of course I will. I'm not really going anywhere.
Then we'll see you soon. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Mary Poppins, Nelius must be so lonely. Could his father ever come to stay?
Anything can happen if you let it.
You won't leave us, will you, Mary Poppins?
We'll see.
How long will you stay?
I'll stay until the wind changes. Now run along in.
Good night, Jane. Good night, Michael. Good night, Mary.
Good night, Bert.
Jane and Michael want to say goodnight.
Tell them you've given me the message.
George, please. Oh, Daddy, we had a fantastic day. We sang with buskers, danced with statues. You wouldn't have approved, but...
If you knew that, then why did you do it?
Daddy, could I have a kite? A proper one?
Could you fly it?
You could always teach me.
And when would I have time to do that?
Daddy, who is the father of Nelius?
Would you please let me get on? Good night.
Poor Michael. All he cares about is flying kites and his beloved astronomy, of course.
I used to love astronomy at his age. My nanny, Miss Andrew, soon beat it out of me.
I suppose we do need a nanny, George. Is it out of the question to do without one?
Don't be absurd. Of course we need a nanny. All the best people have nannies. So the wives do charity work and entertain. Which reminds me, how's your tea party coming on?
I'm not sure. It seems so odd sending out invitations to people I hardly know.
But they're people you should know. Remember, by your own friends shall ye be judged.
But that's just the point. They're not my friends. Actually, I heard today from Clummy Bunting. She's rehearsing a new play at the moment, and I thought I might...
How many times must I tell you? I wish to sever all connections with that part of your life.
I was an actress, George. Lots of people might find that interesting, though you always talk as if I should be ashamed of it.
Well, it's not exactly something to be proud of. Winifred, dearest, I'm only thinking of you. I want people to admire you, to respect you.
I know, George, just sometimes it's hard.
It's not hard. It's your job to be Mrs. Banks.
And what is your job?
To pay for everything? What is it?
I was only going to kiss you.
Oh, all right. Are you going to talk to Mary Poppins about this afternoon?
I don't think so.
Very well. But make sure she does things our way and not hers.
Mind. Yes, come up a little bit. Thank you very much.
Winds do change, tides can turn, sink or swim, see what you learn. Me, I was told, thank you, when I was young, just learn a trade. So I learned 'em all. Chim Chimani, Chim Chim, Chari Chim Chahu.
Morning, Bert. Swabbing the decks today, I see.
Gotta keep the street shipshape, Admiral.
Tell me, how are things aboard number 17? All smooth sailing with Mary Poppins, I trust.
There's some rough weather on every voyage, Admiral.
I tell ye, what these children need is a touch of the cat and a night on the yard.
What those children need, Admiral, is a touch of happiness. Willoughby.
Mrs. Brill, don't make the sandwiches too early. They'll get stale before the guests arrive.
Everything's under control, ma'am.
What about the cake?
Cooling on the tray, waiting to be iced.
And you're quite sure you know how to ice it?
Quite sure. And in case you're worried, I have not been exchanged by the fairies for a total nincompoop.
No.
No.
Well, I'll just go up and check the drawing room.
I'd like to be helpful.
Well, I'd like to be rich, but the good Lord thought otherwise.
Mother wants you in the drawing room.
Well, she can't have me. I've got enough to do as is.
She says you can tell Robertson and I what to do.
Does she indeed? Well, why don't I go and have a smoke by the gaswork? For good measure.
Please, Miss Brill, I don't mind. Honest.
Fine. I will give you one task and one task only. And so help me, if you mess this up, I will swing for you and sing as I pull the lever.
What is it?
Put the icing tools next to the cake. I'll need a bowl of hot water to warm them. I'll make the icing as soon as I get back.
Icing tools, cake, a bowl for the water, and I'll make the icing as soon as I'm back.
Do you think you can manage that?
Is that all?
For you, yes. But for me, after the cake's done, I've the sandwiches to do, because Madame wants them fresh, so I can't start them until there's no time to finish them. I swear, a slave in ancient Rome was on a pleasure cruise compared to my life in this household.
Well, don't just stand there, Robert and I.
Right. No. What are you looking for?
A bowl. For the water.
Michael.
Why don't we make the icing?
Because we don't know how.
Don't be so feeble and get the eggs. If Miss Brill can do it, it can't be that hard.
Are there eggs in icing?
They're on mine.
I don't think Miss Brill would thank you.
Then she'll be guilty of great ingratitude.
Is it supposed to look like this?
It doesn't look like that when Miss Brill does it.
Don't be so impertinent and get the cake.
Honestly, Miss Jane, I was just trying to be helpful, if you would.
Mrs. Brill, go up and get ready now. What have you done? Robertson and I! Oh, dear, should I call the doctor?
I don't think that would be necessary, ma'am.
How could you be so unkind when you know how important my party is? You two deserve some very nasty medicine. Just you wait until bedtime.
Oh, I don't think we should wait till then, ma'am. Why not go up and get changed? We'll clear up, won't we?
But we're not ill. I won't take it, you can't make me.
In that, as in so many things, your information is faulty. Open.
But it's strawberry ice.
Now you.
I'm not sure I like strawberry ice.
And I'm not sure I care. Open.
I'm cordial.
Now we must get started. Michael, I know you like to keep things neat. Jane.
Must we? Can't Robertson do it when she wakes up? She is a servant.
With that attitude, you'll get through a lot of stuff before you're very old. Besides, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun and snap, the job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
medicine, go down. Medicine, go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. The honeybees have fetched the nectar from the flower to the comb, never tire of ever buzzing to and fro, because they take a little nip from every flower that they sip, and hence they find their task is not a grind. For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
Spit spot. Cups on saucers, please. All of them, thank you. Is this how you usually do it, Michael? Rum punch, my favorite.
How did you get them to do it?
Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
The medicine?
Go down, medicine.
Go down.
Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
So, just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
The medicine go down.
Medicine go down.
Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
In a most delightful way.
Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
Off now, ma'am. Jane, Michael, best foot forward.
I'm sorry, ma'am. Apparently these came this morning, and Roberts and I forgot to give them to you. Their apologies, ma'am. From your guest, they're not coming. None of them.
Oh, do you think we chose the wrong day?
No, I think you asked the wrong people.
In a most delightful way.
What are we doing today?
I thought we could play our next game.
What game?
It's called A Visit to the Bank.
That's not a game. Did Daddy agree?
If he did, you must have put the idea into his head somehow.
What an impertinent thing to say. Me, putting ideas into other people's heads. Really.
Good morning, Mr. Chairman.
Good morning. Banks, a word? I see Erevon Hustler is coming in again today. Have you made your decision?
I believe so, sir.
Good, good. Be sure it's the right one.
Mr. Banks, what objections can you possibly have?
My security, it is more than adequate. In Latin America, why, it is an expanding market. What is the matter? Have you no courage?
But, Mr. Von Hustler, what I simply can't grasp is, what exactly is your final product?
What do you think? Money, of course.
Yes, money. But I wonder, making money out of money, is that enough?
Are you man enough to be a banker?
Have you come to your decision, Mr. Banks? There's a town of good people whose future depends on you.
I know that.
Please, give us this chance. You won't regret it. The factory could be up and running in weeks and expanding before the year's out. I'd give it everything I've got. Believe me.
I do believe you, Mr. Northbrook. And I've tried to find a way, but there's just simply not the collateral.
Well, what about my workforce? Decent men who want a better life. They are my collateral.
I'm sorry, Mr. Northbrook, but
Hello there.
What on earth are you doing here? Can't you see that I'm busy?
No, we're done. And no man should be too busy for his own children. Now, what are you here for, young man? Have you come for some money as well?
Hardly. What would they need money for?
Well, it's never too early to learn its value.
I know the value of this. Sixpence.
That's its worth. Its value lies in how you spend it. Do good. And may you have good luck.
And what do you say to Mr. Northbrook?
Thank you.
I'll wait outside.
What is the meaning of all this? Really, Mary Poppins, I am not without a sense of humor.
Aren't you, Daddy?
No, I'm not. But when I was a little boy, I would have never dared interrupt my father while he was working.
Were you ever a little boy?
Yes, I was. But my nanny, Miss Andrew, kept me out of my father's way. And he'd have been very annoyed if she hadn't.
What about your mother?
I shouldn't think I saw either of them more than once a week.
But didn't they mind?
Mind? They were glad to be rid of me.
Then who kissed you goodnight? Miss Andrew?
Oh, surely not. There was no time for hugs and kisses and all that soppy nonsense. What's the matter?
Poor Daddy.
Poor? What do you mean, poor? That's what made me the man I am. Right, Mary Poppins?
Yes, I'm afraid it did.
Oh, well, you've seen my work, and I have a great deal to do.
When you invest in the bank's money, what are you looking for? A good man or a good idea?
I suppose I should say a good idea. But a good man is much rarer and much more valuable.
Come along, children.
Mr. Von Hustler, I've considered the arguments, but I'm afraid my answer is no.
So you do not recognize a good idea?
Perhaps not. But I do recognize a good man when I see one.
You will regret this, Herr Banks.
Feed the birds, Toppence a bag, Toppence, Toppence, Toppence a bag.
Look, there's that horrible old woman.
Don't point. And for your information, she's not in the least bit horrible.
But she's just a bundle of rags.
When will you learn to look past what you see?
Early each day to the steps of St. Paul's, the little old bird woman comes. In her own special way, to the people she calls. Come, buy my bags full of crumbs. Come, feed the little birds,
the birds. Tuppence a bag. Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
Feed the birds, that's what she cries, while overhead her birds fill the skies.
What are you doing?
I want to give her my sixpence. What a waste.
That is a matter of opinion. Here, one bag, please. Save your sixpence, Michael.
All around the cathedral, the saints and apostles look down as she sells her wares. Although you can't see them, you know they are smiling each time someone shows that he cares. Though her words are simple and few, listen, listen, she's calling to you. Feed the birds, tuppence a bag. Tuppence, tuppence, tuppence a bag.
You don't say. Well, here they are now. You can tell them yourself. Will you?
Isn't that Miss Lark's dog, Willoughby?
Don't interrupt when someone's barking. You were saying? Really? Well, if she keeps wandering off, perhaps it would be best if you kept her on a lead.
Willoughby!
Ah, look, here she comes now.
Willoughby! Have you seen my dog, Willoughby?
No?
Oh, it's all right, Mommy's here! You know, sometimes I'd almost think he could talk! But can Willoughby really talk?
Of course he can. Getting him to stop is the problem!
How can you learn to talk, dog?
Well, how do you think? Master the grammar.
Practice when you can.
And avoid mongrels.
Far too much slang.
Now come along. I can't stand here all day talking shop.
Talking shop? That's a silly expression.
There's nothing silly about it in the least.
What do you buy in a talking shop?
Conversations, of course.
Well, I've never seen a talking shop before.
Well, there is only one, and it belongs to Mrs. Corey.
Who's Mrs. Corey?
Who's Mrs. Corey? Who's Mrs. Dinner? No, Mrs. Corey.
I just said I don't have all day.
Oh. Mrs. Corey's the oldest woman in the world. She talked to William before he went conquering, to Vlad before he went impaling, and to Alexander when he wasn't so great.
We'll have to call it a shop in the park.
But there's not a shop in the park.
Remember, anything can happen if you let it.
That's it! I've run out of conversations.
Good day to you, Mrs. Corey.
Well, if it isn't Mary Poppins, with Jane and Michael Banks.
She knows us.
And how is poor little Georgie?
Who?
Georgie Banks, your father. He used to give his nanny to slip and come into my shop here in secret.
But it can't have been the same George Banks. That would have been nearly 40 years ago. No one can remember back that far.
Leah Sandiri, I remember everything. I remember Georgie used to love me gingerbread. I wonder if we've got any left today. Annie, Fanny, look lively.
Yes, Mother!
There you are. Gingerbread pieces with gingerbread stars. Georgie always saved his stars. Now, Mary Poppins, what can I do for you?
Well, I did want an ounce of conversation.
I'm out of conversations, and I'm right out of words, too. You see, we've had a lot of chatterboxes in here today, but let's see what we've got left. I do have some letters and a little bit of back chat.
An ounce, you say? There will be 15 letters. Go on, take your pick.
Jane, you can choose 7.
I've got D, G, R, U, C, L, and I.
They're no good. You can't make a conversation out of them.
Michael, 7 more.
A, F, S, E, T, P, and O.
And I'll choose an X. Now, what words can we make?
Well, I see dog and cat.
Rattleplex, that's 9.
Lepidophorus, that's 11. Nearly there.
Those don't count, you made them up.
And where do you think words came from in the first place? Somebody had to make them up.
Now, of course, we can always use the same letter more than once. Now, let me see.
Super, caliph, ragilistic, expialid, ocious.
That's not a word.
Well, of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, I think it's going to prove a rather useful one.
When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. When Stone Age men were chatting, simply grunting would suffice.
Oh, if they heard this word, they might have used it once or twice.
That's right.
I'm sure Egyptian pharaohs would have grasped it in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
Then every single pyramid would bear this hieroglyph. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Say it and rub, animals will not seem so ferocious.
Add some further flourishes, it's super-po-po-cocious.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
The Druids could have carved it on the mighty monoliths.
Oh yes.
The ancient Greeks, I'm certain, would have used it in their myths.
I'm sure the Roman Empire only entered the abyss because those Latin scholars never had a word like this.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
If you say it softly, the effect can be hypnotious.
Check your breath before you speak in cases malitocious.
Oh, but...
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
You can say it backwards, which is sui record alive, excepts the gar for the crepus.
She may be tricky, but she's bloody good.
So when the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say.
Pick out those 18 consonants, add 16 vowels as well, and put them in an order which is very hard to spell.
S-U-P-E-R-C-A-L-I-F
F-R-A-G-I-L
I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D-O-C-I-O-U-S
Woo! Spurty pants.
S-U-P-E-R-C-A-L-I-F R-A-G-I-L I-S-T-I-C-E-X-P-I-A-L-I-D-O-C-I-O-U-S.
Thou wins my blow, but who's to know exactly what it's bringing? Good news or bad, happy or sad, the pendulum keeps swinging.
Right, stand there and hold this. You are never to come near this vase. It is an heirloom.
Heirloom.
And while I do this, stay totally immobile.
Immobile.
Do not move a muscle.
Muscle?
Do not breathe. Do you hear me?
I might as well be dead.
Don't give me ideas.
A game is played, a change is made, but still the road is long. And though they might yet fly a kite, sometimes the wind's too strong.
George, what's happened? Are you ill?
No. Should I be?
Of course not. Only, why on earth are you home so early? Is everything all right?
No. Everything's all wrong.
My dear, what is it?
If you must know, I refuse this German chap alone. Turns out he went to our chief rivals. They gave him the money. Has turned into a gold mine.
Well, they can't expect you to get it right every time.
Can't they? That's exactly what they expect.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious. If you say it loud enough...
That is more than loud enough.
But we were just...
I don't care what you were just. To your room now. My briefcase. Jane, Michael, would you give it to me? Must I put up with this behavior? You're their mother. Can't you do something?
I can try not shouting for a start.
Mary Poppins, you're here to teach the children manners. And look at them. They're a pair of little savages. If I had my way, you'd be out of this house by...
George, you're tired. Mary Poppins, don't bring the children downstairs tonight. Mr. Banks is quite exhausted. Perhaps you could keep them occupied.
I hope you haven't forgotten, ma'am, but tonight is my evening out.
Oh, dear, I had forgotten. I suppose the best people wouldn't ask you to change your plans.
No, ma'am, they wouldn't.
I thought not.
It's not fair. Daddy loses his temper and worse up in the nursery. Daddy's mean and rotten, and I hate him!
Jane! Take that back this instant! I will not have you criticize your father!
Why not? He criticizes you. Last week he said you were neither use nor ornament.
How dare you!
I heard him and so did you!
Sometimes people say things they don't mean. Mary Poppins, take the children upstairs now, please. George?
What is it now?
I thought you might like to talk about it.
And what would be the point?
Perhaps I can help.
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
I'm serious, George. If you have troubles, I'd like to share them.
Don't worry. You will. The truth is, I've been suspended without salary until the bank decides what to do with me.
Legs up. There you go. Thank you. Legs up. Thank you. Twists and turns, ups and downs. One moment smiles, next moment frowns. But bad-tempered faces had better change quick. 'Cause if the wind changes, their face might just stick. Chim chimani chim chim chari chim charu. Up where the smoke is all billowed and curled, between pavement and stars is a chimney sweep's world, where there's hardly no day, nor hardly no night. There's things off in shadow and off-ways in light, on the rooftops of London. What a sight!
Oh, so you're a sweep now, are you?
The best view in the world. And who gets to see it? The birds, the stars, and the chimney sweeps. Nothing to beat it. Now, as the ladder of life has been strung, you might think a sweep's on the bottom most rung. Though I spends me time in the ashes and smoke, in this so-high world, there's no happier bloke. Chim-chimani, chim-chimani, chim-chim-chari, a sweep is as lucky can be. Chim-chimani, chim-chimani, chim-chim-charu,
good luck will rub off when he shakes hands with you.
Oh, blow me a kiss,
but...
and that's lucky too. So, you're off then.
The wind's changed.
They're good kids, Mary.
Would I be bothering with them if they weren't? But I can't help them if they won't let me. And no one is so hard to teach as a child who knows everything.
So?
So they've got to do this next bit on their own.
Chim-chimani, chim-chimani, chim-chim-chari.
When you're with a sweep, you're in glad company. Goodbye, Bert.
Chim, chim, chim-chim-chari. When you're with a sweep, you're in glad company. Nowhere is there a more happier crew than them's what sing chim-chim-chari, chim-charu. Chim-chimani, chim-chim-chari, chim-char.
Cheerio, Bert. Look after them for me.
She can't have left us.
Yes, she can.
What does the note say?
What in the name of heaven are you two doing out here? Where's Mary Poppins?
She's gone.
Gone? Well, if that doesn't take the bloomin' biscuit.
Miss Brill, what does au revoir mean?
Why?
Because that's what it says here in this note. Dear Jane and Michael, keep playing the games. Au revoir, Mary Poppins.
It's French, I know that. Doesn't mean God bless you or good luck. No, I remember now. Until we meet again. Now come inside before you catch your death.
Is the nursery tidy?
As tidy as I can make it, Mom.
If you knew how hard it was to track her down.
Really? Fancy that.
Mrs. Brill, it is her, isn't it?
Well, I don't know who else it would be.
Why is it such a secret?
The note said till we meet again.
Oh my goodness, she'll be here any moment. Now, where is George?
George? Dear, you're going to be surprised.
Winifred. You know I hate surprise at the best of times.
Oh, not this one. George, I do believe you're going to be proud of me for once. Now, everyone into the hall. I want you to find everything spit, spot, spick, and span.
Good morning.
The holy terror.
Miss Andrew, it's so lovely to meet you at last. I do hope you had a good journey.
It was thoroughly unpleasant. I never enjoy travel. You must be poor George's wife. Your flower beds are disgracefully untidy. Take my advice. Plants evergreens. Or better yet, have nothing there at all. Just a plain cement courtyard.
Oh, but dear Miss Andrew, we are so fond of flowers.
Then you're a very silly woman. Now, where is George?
I'm afraid he had an urgent appointment.
For which, no doubt, he was late, as usual. It's not much of a house, is it?
We like it.
Then it doesn't take a lot to keep you happy. Look at the dust. There, and there. Filth!
We are rather short-staffed at the moment.
Hasn't anybody ever cleaned these curtains?
Now, just a minute.
Ah, and you must be the children. Pity, I don't suppose you know who I am.
Yes, we do. You're the holy terror.
Impudent boy! And you're Jane, I suppose. Why aren't you wearing any stockings?
I don't like them.
Tut! What manners! I can see I've arrived in the nick of time. These children have been spoiled. I've arrived here just in time. By chance, I've brought the punishment that best befits the crime. Brimstone and treacle and cod liver oil, liberal doses of each. These are the treats from which children recoil, the lessons I'm going to teach. Just follow my model and don't mollycoddle, it may lead the irksome to irk. So seek satisfaction from punitive action. Brimstone and treacle will work. Open.
Does it taste as bad as it smells?
Worse.
Do I have to?
Well, I...
Open! Brimstone and treacle and carbolic soap. These are the tools of my trade. With spoonfuls of sugar, you don't have a hope of seeing that changes are made. Where manners are chronic, my tincture's the tonic that's certain to wipe off a smirk. Just dole out a ration in matronly fashion. Brimstone and treacle will work. Your son will go to boarding school at once. And as for the girl, I shall take charge of her myself. I won't stand for whining or whinging or whimpering, crying or lying or sobbing or simpering. I fear it's clear that in these two such bad habits lurk. First threaten to throttle, then uncork the bottle. Brimstone and treacle will work. Now show me to my room. Brimstone and treacle will work.
She can't stay. They'll have to dismiss her. You know, I'm disappointed. Truly I am. I thought it'd be, you know, with the umbrella.
What are we going to do?
The only thing we can do. Run away!
Thank you.
Easy now, your old friend ain't gonna hurt you.
Oh, Bert, it's you.
You're filthy.
Perhaps a smudge or two. Just so happens to die. I'm a chimney sweep. So, who's after you?
The nastiest nanny in the world.
The nastiest nanny in the world, aye? Well, you two should know. You've been through an awful lot of them. Is she really as bad as all that?
She looks like something that would eat its young.
Oh, my.
Miss Andrew is Daddy's nanny.
Which explains a lot.
Poor Daddy, ever since he stopped working, he just sits and mopes. Mary Poppins used to say we had to help him, but now it's too late.
I wouldn't say that. Tell you what, why don't we start things off with a bit of a shake for good luck?
Why would shaking hands with you bring us luck?
Hasn't anyone ever told you shaking hands with a chimney sweep is good luck? There you go.
But what do you do if you want some luck?
I shake hands with myself. Now, what have we got here?
Michael, look, it's a real one.
A bit tangled.
What's the matter? You've always wanted to fly a proper kite.
I've always wanted to fly one with Daddy.
Of course you have, but you got to get some practice in. Learn the trick of the trade, and then once you do, you'll make him the proudest father in the whole country.
Do you really think so? You're not just saying that.
Did I say country? I meant the old blooming empire. With Poppins for paper and strings, you can have your own set of wings. With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight, with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite. A bit tangled. There you go.
Try again.
What's this? You don't allow litter here!
It isn't litter, it's a kite!
Oh, a kite, is it? My word, I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy. I will wind her up, give her a run, and away she'll go.
I want to do it.
But you'll let me help, won't you? Seeing as how I haven't flown a kite since I was a boy.
Oh, all right.
I knew you'd come back.
Don't squeeze. I am not a sardine in a tin. And where are your coats?
We didn't have time to put them on.
And why not, may I ask? Because we've run away.
Have you indeed? Mary Poppins, it's been so awful since you went away. And now Miss Andrew's come and Daddy's ruined and we never helped him like he wanted us to.
Oh my eye, but your life's a tragedy. Now let's go home and don't dawdle.
But she's there. She came this morning as a surprise for Daddy.
Did she? Well, maybe I'll be a surprise for her. That was a lovely greeting, Bert.
I meant it, Mary. You're a sight for sore eyes.
You really are, Mary Poppins. Welcome back.
Told you they were good kids.
And I told you they were worth bothering with.
Now see here! It's against the regulations, coming down from the sky like that. And where from, I'd like to know, eh? Where from?
If I were a park keeper, I should straighten my cap and button my coat. Now let's go home.
Aren't you going to shake hands with Bert for luck?
No.
Why not? We have.
I don't need any luck, thank you.
She's killed everyone. Perhaps they're all dead.
Not like that, you stupid boy!
They're not all dead.
What was that? It's a bird. Oh, I might have known.
Did she? Well, frankly, that's not a surprise. Locked in this cage and not free in the skies for 2 years. How shameful. Yes, of course, that's a field I know well. An hour no longer, your wings will grow stronger. Once you are free from this cell.
What kind of bird is it?
A lark. You are seeing a lark in a cage for the first time and the last. My pleasure. Oh, don't mention it.
I'm going downstairs to fetch Caruso, my lark. You stay there and clean the grate again. Ah, so you've decided to come crawling back, have you? Well, I think we know what's needed now. Brimstone and treacle, my favorite liquor. That will make runaways stop. Impudent children respond so much quicker when forced to drink every last drop.
Is this what you're looking for?
Who are you?
I'm Mary Poppins.
Mary Poppins? But you left without notice.
And I've come back without notice.
I see. And what do you expect me to do about that?
Pack.
Pack! You insolent young person! How dare you speak to me in that way? Silly little girl with your newfangled methods. I bring up children so they know their place. Standing for tradition, I govern my charges.
Mishandled charges blow up in your face.
I brought up their father.
Well, that I don't doubt. You must be so proud of the way he turned out.
A shining example, a pillar,
a post. They all have their problems, but him more than most.
Caruso? Where's my lark? Caruso! You let my little lark out of his cage. Now you will bear the full brunt of my rage. Brimstone and treacle for you. Brimstone and treacle for you.
Just a spoonful of sugar.
Brimstone and treacle for you.
Just a spoonful of sugar.
Brimstone and treacle for you.
Just a spoonful of sugar.
I recognize fully that you are in the lead.
Poppins, wherever did you come from?
She came from up Michael.
Michael? Jane, is that you? Oh, thank heavens.
But you're very naughty to go running off like that, and I should be as angry as anything. If I weren't so pleased to see you.
Where's Miss Andrew?
She's gone.
Gone? Why?
She didn't give a reason, ma'am.
How peculiar. So, Mary Poppins, if you're back, are you going to stay?
I'll stay for as long as necessary, ma'am.
Because the last time you were here, you left without a word of warning. How do I know you won't do it again?
You don't.
Oh.
Excuse me, ma'am?
Constable, I'm so sorry I bothered you, but it's quite all right. They're back and...
Not all of them, ma'am.
What?
We found this one wandering in the park.
George?
Where is she?
Miss Andrew? She left.
Left? but how?
She might have thought we were rude.
Rude? To Miss Andrew? Well, I can't forgive it. But I'll try to forget. In fact, I'd have given you 6 pence if I had one.
George, you hadn't noticed. Mary Poppins is back.
Ah, yes. I wonder if I might have a word. There's no point in beating around the bush. Things have not gone well for us since you left.
About my wages, sir. If you don't mind, I won't collect any just now. I would prefer to let them accrue.
But Mary Poppins, if only you knew how much was accruing as it is.
Is everything settled?
It is. Now I must get started. Jane, Michael, Spitzbot. Are the drains playing up, or is Mrs. Brill cooking?
Come along, darling. You made a wrong decision, but how bad is that? After so many years of good service, what's the worst that could happen?
Winifred, if I am to be dismissed by the bank, we'll be destitute. The servants will leave, the house will be repossessed, and we'll be outside with the children sitting on the frosty curbside.
But we'll still have what really matters, the children. And each other. New?
And if it is?
What's inside it?
A portrait.
Whose?
You'll know when the time comes and not before.
How long will you stay?
I'll stay until the chain breaks.
What? What chain? Where?
Michael, you must be careful. The room's a bit excited to see me back, and you never know what might happen around a fireplace.
Mary Poppins! Mary Poppins, help!
Michael! Michael, come back! Mary Poppins, help!
Off we go.
Bert, what are you doing up here?
Well, should a chimney sweep be?
Oh, what do I look like? That's better.
The world is awfully big, isn't it?
And what does that tell you?
That we are awfully small and unimportant?
Oh, speak for yourself.
Not
us so much, but our problems, they seem so big down in the nursery, and up here.
That's more like it. Our problems never seem so bad when we look at them from a little higher up. And always remember, there's plenty of folk that'll help you along the way, should you need them.
Who?
Brush away the dirt and soot. Brush away your tears. Cobwebs that are swept away hang around for years. We may look a mocking through the morning. Smudge it far and wide. But when you need a helping hand, we try to step in.
It's the same.
Never miss a chance to get it right.
Woo! Don't seem a perfect crime, don't seem a shine. When the steps aren't going as smoothly as they might.
Not so fast. Mary Poppins, would you be good enough to explain all this?
First of all, I would like to make one thing quite clear.
Yes?
I never explain anything. Come along, children.
Winifred? I'm afraid the time has come. The bank wants to see me at the close of business tonight.
Tonight? Well, I'm going to come with you and jolly well give your chairman a piece of my mind.
That would only make matters worse. We might as well face it. In just a few hours, we'll have joined the ranks of the unemployed.
George, are you quite sure?
Quite sure. So we'd better make some plans.
Do you mean your mother's vase? Won't you miss it terribly?
Needs must, my dear. We always said we were saving it for a rainy day, and tomorrow, it'll set the pour.
Oh, George, do be careful!
The heirloom!
Mrs. Brill, let's go to the kitchen, shall we? You'd
better sit down.
Mrs. Brill, is the dinner cooking?
Don't you start with me. I've opened all the windows.
I was only going to say it smells delicious.
This world has gone upside down.
Father?
Yes?
We've come to say goodnight.
Oh, yes. Goodnight.
Do you remember when we came to the bank?
Yes.
Well, we were each given a sixpence and told to spend them wisely.
Excellent advice. That's exactly what you should do. What'd you buy with them?
Nothing. We kept them, and now we've decided to give them to you.
I suppose Mary Poppins put you up to this?
No, she hasn't said a word. But we know things have been difficult and we really haven't been that much help.
So we thought a bit of extra cash might loosen things up a little.
It's a whole shilling.
Thank you.
Good night, Daddy. We do love you, you know.
Jane, do you remember you once asked me who Nelius's father was?
Yes.
It was Poseidon, King of the Sea. Good night.
Mummy, Daddy's really worried, isn't he?
Yes, he is. But always remember that he loves you very much, and that's far more important than jobs and houses and anything else.
Are you going to the bank with him?
I wish he'd let me. If only there was someone there for him, to take his part, to show them what he's really like on the inside.
Why can't he do that for himself?
Because he's a man. And a very proud one.
Then you must go.
I'd like to go, but I'm afraid it just isn't possible.
Why not?
Because I'm a woman.
Mary Poppins says that anything is possible if we can only get out of our own way.
Do you really believe that, Mary Poppins?
Anything can happen if you let it. Sometimes things are difficult, but you can bet it doesn't have to be so.
Changes can be made.
You can move a mountain if you use a larger spade.
Anything can happen, it's a marvel.
You can be a butterfly
or just stay level.
Stretch your mind beyond fantastic. Dreams are made of strong elastic.
Take some sound advice and don't forget it.
Anything can happen if you let it.
If you reach for the stars, all you get are the stars. But we found a whole new spin. If you reach for the heavens, you get the stars thrown in.
Off to bed now, you two.
I would take it as a great favor if you would kindly feed them for me.
Mr. Banks is here to see you.
Ah, come in, Banks. Well, Banks,
How did it happen? You turned down a scheme that was bound to make millions, and we want to know why.
And I'll tell you. I refused Mr. Von Hustler because the scheme was shallow. It had no product. It had no substance. It had no meaning outside the walls of a bank. Sure, he talked about assets and profits and growth, but there wasn't a word about the people. I know that if a man puts any value in real life, as far as you're concerned, he's a washout. But I'm afraid I do value it, gentlemen. In short, George Banks Esquire has rediscovered the human race. I apologize for ruining the bank, but I do not apologize for understanding that there are more important things in life than making money.
Ruining the bank? Ruining the bank? My dear chap, what are you talking about? Haven't you heard? You've saved our bacon. Von Hustler's scheme has ruined our rival. You kept us out of the nastiest scandal since records began. We don't want your apology. We're offering ours.
Oh, my word.
And another thing. Do you remember giving a loan to a fellow called Northbrook? Well, he's repaying it and opening two new factories. With the percentage you negotiated, we look set to make a fortune.
Oh, my word.
Well, that's just it. We very much hope you'll tell us how you did it. Just give us the word, and it'll be quite safe with us.
Give you the word. Give you the word. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Hosa, thank you.
Now, Banks.
Forgive him. It's not his fault. It's all because of his nanny, Miss Andrew.
The Holy Terror? She taught me everything I know.
Then now's your chance to forget it.
That's right. And if you want to fight about it, you've come to the right woman.
That's quite all right, dear. It's quite all right. I haven't lost money at all. I've made the bank a fortune.
Really?
Madame, if you'd please, we still have some business to conduct. Ah, well, Banks, George, by way of recompense, we'd like to offer you the job of senior manager with salary at double.
Exactly how much has he made for you?
Triple. Quadruple your present rate.
Close your mouth, George. We are not a codfish.
Well?
I accept. But you must understand one thing. From now on, my family comes first.
Agreed? Agreed.
Winifred, I'm afraid I've underestimated you. How can you forgive me?
How can you ask?
It was selfish of me to keep you off the stage. You'll want to go back, and I won't mind if you do.
No. I've loved it, but I've found a role I rather prefer. And it's going to keep me extremely busy for a very long time.
Mary Poppins, Neelius and Poseidon will live happily ever after, won't they?
Of course.
Oh, Mary Poppins, that was the best yet, to be up in the heavens. Do you think we'll ever go back?
Yes, someday.
Really, will it be soon?
Oh no, not for a very long time. You can always keep an eye on the stars until you return. Here.
But it's your telescope.
So it is. But keep it if you like. It's a present.
Thank you.
Now run along in, it's getting cold.
I love you, Mary Poppins.
You are a fine boy, Michael Banks. And one day you will be a fine man.
Oh, Mary Poppins, it makes me so anxious when you talk like that.
Like what?
All gentle and kind and not a bit like yourself. Do be cross again, Mary Poppins.
Is that the thanks I get for the trouble I've taken?
That's better.
That's dainty, Bert.
Oh, the oars, Mary. I painted them for you. It's tonight, isn't it?
Yes, Bert.
Well, goodbye then, Mary.
Goodbye, Bert. Look after yourself.
With every job, when it's complete, there is a sense of bittersweet. That moment when you know the task is done. Though in your heart you'd like to stay to help things on their way, you've always known they must do it alone.
There, practically perfect, and I hope it remains so.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming. I hope you all enjoyed the show. And it wouldn't be possible without so many people that we want to give thanks to right now. So first of all, I want to thank Mrs. Fuller and Mrs. Pesterman. For the lovely set and all the hair and makeup that you see, thank you to them. I would like to call up Hayden Cole if he's here. Flowers to say thank you. Next week we have Miss Smith. Miss Smith is our production manager. Director Miss Walsh.